Well, Senator Nancy Binay has called the tourism department's Love the Philippines campaign unsalvageable following the promotional video fiasco. Senator Nancy Binay now joins us on the line. Senator, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Ms. Carmina, and good afternoon to all your viewers.
Senator Binay, as you just reported, you called the Love the Philippines promotional video unsalvageable. But will you be calling an investigation into it?
Actually, I'm still thinking whether to file a resolution calling for an investigation on the viability of the Love the Philippines slogan. But as you know, Carmina will be going back to work this coming July, on the 3rd week of July, and we will be starting our deliberation on the budget. So I'm thinking maybe we can just do that during the budget deliberation.
Mm-hmm. But will you be able to arrive at the answers, for example, that many people are asking about why the controversy even had to happen during the budget deliberation, Senator?
I think so, but I'm really thinking about filing a resolution just to focus on this issue.
Mm-hmm. What's the thought process, Senator? What are you weighing?
Well, number one, what is really the status of the contract between DOT and DDB? Because based on your news report, not a single cent has been paid to DDB. So what is the engagement? Well, technically, who owns the tagline, Love the Philippines, if no single centavo is spent on it? So that's one. And the viability of the slogan itself, as you know, it was already reported in the international media. And in fact, the Indonesian foreign minister talked about it, that Indonesians should give thanks to the Philippines for showing their rice paddies. So with all these controversies, can we still use the slogan, Love the Philippines?
Mm-hmm. But when you course all these questions through the budget deliberation, Senator, will you be able to call in the DDB, for example, to answer some of your questions?
Maybe not. That is why we are thinking of filing a resolution.
Mm-hmm. The treatment...
My appeal to DOT is... Because at the moment, there's still... insistent on using the Love the Philippines slogan, but with all the controversy. So my appeal to them is to think twice, and you know, it's either they go back to more fun or think of another slogan.
Which brings me to my next question. They're adamant on using it. It's as if they're functioning above the noise. I mean, I guess that's one way to move on from the controversy, but from your perspective, what does that tell you? When it seems like they're sticking to a script, they're not about to just engage in, you know, these back and forth of questions from the public. They're just going ahead with their plans as if nothing happened. What does that tell you?
If you remember, during the time of Secretary Juan Dateo, we also went through the same brouhaha. They were trying to change the slogan from "It's more fun" to "Experience the Philippines." And then there was also a copyright issue. So then Secretary Teo just decided to just go back to "It's more fun." So my appeal to the Secretary is, at the moment, we have limited sources to start another campaign. So at this point, maybe it's a sign that it's time to go back to "It's more fun."
Mm-hmm. But it seems like they're not about to do so, Senator. And what does that tell you?
We will continue our appeal. And maybe when we do conduct a hearing, maybe all the issues can be raised. Mm-hmm. Or maybe it's also a chance for DOT to prove to all of us why Love the Philippines slogan is still viable. Mm-hmm.
Going back to the investigation that has not happened yet, Madam Senator, that's also one of the questions being asked. Why is there no such commitment coming from the senators or your counterparts at the lower house? Why is there no commitment to get to the bottom of things via an investigation in either house?
I can't speak for my colleagues, but maybe we will hear more about it when the session starts, because at the moment we're still on break. Mm-mm. So maybe during that time, but you know, I can't speak for them.
Mm-mm. But for you, for example, you're the chairman of the Tourism Committee at the Senate, right? Why hasn't...
Yes, so for me at the moment, I'm still thinking of filing, but you know, during the budget deliberations, all issues can be discussed, and maybe this can be a focus of the budget deliberation, because as you know, we will be spending a lot of money for this campaign.
Mm-hmm. But there's also the point of you know, this the factor of the DDB. They also released their own statement and they left it at that. We, for one, here, we've been trying to get in touch with them. We've been trying to tell them to, you know, come to the show and answer the questions, but the line that they give us is that they defer to the statement. What explanation, as chairman of the Senate Committee on Tourism, what other explanation do you want from the DDP? Do you want to hear from them?
Maybe we want to avoid a similar scenario. So maybe it's best to know what went wrong with the process moving forward. Because this is already the second time that this happened for a DOT campaign. As I've mentioned during the time of Secretary Wanda, a similar scenario happened, and then, you know, 6 years after, it still happened. So maybe it's high time for us to know, maybe there's something wrong with the DOT process in approving or checking. Mm-hmm. Maybe we need to know the process. We need to know the protocol.
Mm. As you're in the process, Madam Senator, of thinking whether or not you should conduct an investigation into this whole controversy, how much value do you give to the clamor of people to hold those responsible accountable, and that they can only see this and really know that this is happening through an investigation? How much weight do you put into that?
Well, and at the moment, you should also hear the side of DOT after their investigation, because I heard they also doing their own internal investigation. So maybe it's also prudent for us to wait on the final results of their internal investigation.
Mm-hmm. For example, when you hear the name of Director Paul Soriano being included in this whole fiasco, do you think that he should also be answering all these queries, and that can only take place via an investigation and not through statements, or not by keeping quiet and pretending it never happened?
But you know, at this point, Carmina, it's all it's just Marites. I've heard the name of Paul Soriano, but you know, no mention was given by DDB about that, or even Secretary Fasco didn't also mention that.
Mm. Do you feel now that it's up to you, as chairman of the Senate Committee, to Tourism Committee, to get to the bottom of this and really find out the answers? Because we're not getting it from anyone.
Yeah, and I think we do. If we do have the hearing, when we discuss about the protocols, maybe we will really know what went wrong with the process, or what was the process used when they approved this AVP and the slogan.
Mm-hmm. In the meantime,
because
though,
technically this is not the ad that we will be using when we do placement. This was just the AVP used for the launch during the 50th anniversary of the department.
Mm-hmm. In the meantime, though, as you still weigh things, or you still are weighing things about whether or not to conduct the investigation or pose your questions via the budget deliberations and that appeal, do you think that I mean, the tourism department has this whole program ahead of it. After the launch, and they're continuing with it. They have the hop on, hop off that was launched just yesterday. They also have other activities planned. Without having a slogan, how do you think they're going to go about things?
Well, I think at the moment they're still using love, because I've seen the hop on, hop off buses, and part of the design of the bus are the slogans there, love the Philippines. So maybe at the moment they'll just continue using that.
And then just shift again to another one?
Maybe. Hopefully they'll shift again, or maybe we can just also appeal if they can pause for a while and just use it's more fun.
Aside from your appeal to Secretary Frasco not to use the slogan Love the Philippines until everything is threshed out, what else do you want to hear from her in terms of answering, what people have been talking about
that,
the past days?
Usually for campaigns like this, there's always a science to it. It should be backed by a study, whether or not that slogan would really work for us. So maybe that is one document that you want to see if we do have the hearing.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. Senator Nancy Binay there, Chairman of the Senate Tourism Committee, thank you so much for taking our call. Ingat po.
Thank you, Ms. Carmina.
Ingat po.